Welcome, future Spartans, friends and family. Welcome to Admitted Spartan Day. Before we start, I have a few items that I'd like to go through to help us work through this webinar, some housekeeping items. First of all, I'd like you to know that we are in webinar mode, which means that we can't see you and we can't hear you. Doesn't matter if your camera's on, so don't worry about if you didn't clean the house or if someone walks behind your camera or the cat walks in, it won't bother us. Secondly, I want you to know that we are recording this webinar so that others who weren't able to join us today can watch it later in the week. And also that we're using the chat feature so that you can put any questions you might have in the chat. If you're not familiar with the chat feature, it's at the bottom of your screen. And it looks like a talk bubble that you might see in a cartoon. If you click on that little icon, the chat will come up and you should be able to chat with anybody, chat with us, we'll be able to see it. And anybody else joining us in this webinar will be able to see it too. So I'm so glad that you are considering joining us at SJSU. There is so much to love about this university. Today, Michael and I want to share a few highlights about the university and answer any general questions you might have about anything about the university. So next week, you're going to have an opportunity to meet with advisors and talk about more detailed questions you might have. My name is Thalia Anagnos. I am the Vice Provost of Undergraduate Education here at San Jose State University. Before we go on, I want to learn a little bit about who's joining us today. So we have a poll for you to tell us where you're joining us from. Ashley, can you start the poll? So there's actually two poll questions showing up there. The first is, where are you joining us from today? And the second is, how much have you seen of our campus? It's looking to me like we have a lot of visitors from the San Francisco Bay Area. Yay! And then a few from other parts of California. I'm from Southern California myself. Whoever the one person is from out of state, I'd love you to write the name of the state you're joining us from in the chat so we can see where you're joining us from. I can see that quite a few of you have, wow, North Carolina, amazing. That's fantastic. I can see that a lot of you have been able to walk around our beautiful campus, and it really is an oasis in the middle of downtown San Jose, and it's very exciting. Our campus is an exciting place because we have this vibrant city around us. Some have taken the virtual tour, which is wonderful. And some have only been able to visit our website so far. And I hope after today's welcome, you'll have an opportunity to go back to that website and click on the virtual tour feature and see a little bit more about our campus. And some people haven't even had a chance yet to see the website. So maybe after this, you'll go to www.sjsu.edu and visit our website. For those of you who've had a chance to visit our campus, either virtually, in person, or by the website, I would be really interested for you to put into the chat something that you really liked about what you saw on the campus, or something you really want to explore when you get here. And I'll use that a little bit later to maybe answer some questions you might have about the university. With that, I'm going to end this poll. Ah, the gym, we'll talk about that. Okay, so. So one of the, looking at the people joining us, one of the many great features about San Jose State is that we enroll students from around the world, around the country. And as a Spartan, you'll have an opportunity to meet with students from all walks of life. I want to tell you a little bit about myself. I'm an earthquake engineer by training, and earthquake engineering is a field that engages a variety of different disciplines to implement strategies to reduce death and losses in future earthquakes. Some of the examples of the disciplines that I work with are earth scientists, engineers, sociologists, economists, health professionals, emergency response experts, and government decision makers. And the reason I wanted to share my professional background with you is because when I started college, I had no idea about what I wanted to do. So to help me decide, I took some general education classes and I tried to use those to help me explore some of the opportunities that I wanted to think about. So one day I was sitting in a class and a professor started to talk about how he had just come back from Guatemala after a huge earthquake down there. And he talked about the damage and impact on people's lives, and almost in tears, he emphasized how with better quality construction, inclusive public policies, and better collaboration among all of the fields that I just mentioned a minute ago, we could save hundreds of thousands of lives and prevent so much misery. Well, I was hooked. Like, I thought, okay, that's what I wanna do. I had never heard of earthquake engineering before. In fact, I hardly knew anything that engineering was a field. But at that moment, my life was changed. And so just like my experience as undeclared students, you're gonna find that your first year at San Jose State will be an opportunity to explore your interests and which majors can lead to careers that you'd like to pursue. We have an outstanding career center that can help you understand about what your strengths are, what your interests are, and help you connect those interests to majors here we have on campus. Your SJSU journey, it's gonna open so many opportunities for you that you might not have considered before, just like with me. And I want to encourage you to explore everything while you're here. So for example, we have more than 450 student clubs where you can meet people who have similar passions to you. You can participate in service learning projects to help with things in the local community, or in research projects to help create new knowledge. You could write for the Spartan Daily newspaper. You could join a dance troupe. You could attend a guest speaker. We have so many amazing guest speakers that come to campus. Or you could study abroad. These are just a few choices. I mean, I could go on for hours, but we only have half an hour. So in my current position, I help oversee our more than 200 outstanding undergraduate majors and minors, and you have a lot to choose from. A few examples are advertising, business, climate science, communication disorders, engineering, global studies, marine biology, public health, sociology. These are just a few of the many, many choices you have. So I want you to check out our catalog at catalog.sjsu.edu, which I will put in the chat in a minute so that you'll have that URL so you can check it out, so that you can see the wide ranges of degrees we offer. And that's one of the things that makes San Jose State so great, is that there's this wide range of opportunities, and no matter what you want to do, there is something for you. So I want to introduce Associate Director of Academic Advising and Retention Services, Michael Randle, and he's going to talk to you a little bit more about the advising opportunities here. And then I'll be checking out the chat, see what kind of questions you have, and share a little bit more about some of the things you're interested in. And thank you, Ashley, for putting the catalog in the chat. Michael?
Hi, everybody. My name is Michael Randle. I've been at San Jose State for approximately 25 years. My main role today is to try to give you some kind of self-assurance about making San Jose State your number one destination for your college education. San Jose State is a great place to go to school. Personally, I've been at a number of institutions. Between the ones I've attended and the ones I've worked with, I've been at about five or six institutions. I've been at UC Santa Cruz. I've been at Cal State LA. I've been at Cal State Stanislaus. And the place I finally chose as my home was San Jose State. One of the things I like about San Jose State is the diversity of students, staff, and faculty. What you're going to find is we are not all cut from the same cloth. A number of students, for example, are surprised to find that I come from South Central LA. When I say South Central LA, I mean near USC, 50th and Broadway. And I think it's important to understand that no matter who you are, you fit in here. And I can't overemphasize that. Just fundamentally understand that no matter who you are, where you come from, what your background is, you fit in here. Now, as an undeclared student, what I want you to know is that there are 16 professionals that are dedicated to helping you navigate the institution and dedicated to helping you figure out what you want to be when you grow up, or at the very least, a major to select while you're here. One of the things I want to caution you about is do not judge the person you're going to become by the person you are today. You are here to grow and to develop. So you are not who you're going to be. You're on a road to who you're going to be. So never be afraid of tomorrow, because tomorrow is in front of you. Now, let's answer some questions. Is it possible to graduate from San Jose State in 4 years? The answer is yes. However, a lot of it's going to depend on you. It's going to depend on the advising you get and making sure that you have a game plan for getting out of here in 4 years. Can you supplement your education with summer classes from community college and other institutions? The answer is yes. So I want you to understand that it is fundamentally possible to get out of here in 4 years. Also, in terms of being undeclared, we sort of have two groups for you who are undeclared. We have people who applied undeclared, and you're here to determine for yourself what your future is going to be and what major you're going to get into. But we also have another group of you who applied to a major, and you didn't get your first choice of major, so you're undeclared. So some of you are wondering right now, how do I get into a major? Do I have to transfer schools? Do I got to go to a UC? The answer is you can still get into the major of your choice. But what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to do the research to find out what you need to do to get into that major. Then you're going to have to pursue that avenue and then ultimately apply to and get into that major. So if you apply to a major and you wound up being undeclared, that is not a statement that you cannot get into that major. It just simply means that at this moment in time, that major was unavailable to you. So when you get here, the first thing you want to do is you want to start working with your advisors to start implementing a plan to get into the major of your choice. So I guess if I have to leave you with a message at all, what I want you to fundamentally understand is at San Jose State, all things are possible. And we believe in you. So what we need you to do is we need you to believe in yourself, access the resources that are here, and then go for it. It's just that simple. Just go for it. And if you go for it, we'll be here for you. So with that said, I think we're going to look into some of the chats and see what kind of questions you guys have and see if we can knock them out of the park for you. Thalia?
Michael, could you talk a little bit about undeclared pre-nursing? There's a question in here, is pre-nursing considered an undeclared major? So could you talk a little bit about that particular undeclared option?
Yeah, so let's talk about what it means to be undeclared as a concept, and then we're going to segue from that to undeclared pre-nursing. Undeclared is a designation that students have who do not have a formalized major. There is a group of students who have as an intention to major in nursing. So before you actually get into the nursing program, we don't have what you would call a pre-nursing program. So at that point in your past, you're considered undeclared, but we have a group of advisors that are dedicated to getting you into the track to apply to nursing. That designation is undeclared pre-nursing. So undeclared pre-nursing has its own team of advisors. What they do is work with you on the pre-nursing curriculum and make sure that you are on a track so that later on in your career, you can formally apply to the nursing program.
Great, thanks, Michael. There was a question here, which I think is, you answered previously, but I just wanna reiterate it because it's such an important question. And it says, are we still able to graduate in 4 years even if we were undeclared? The answer is yes. But as Michael indicated previously, the really important piece is to work closely with an advisor. The advisors can ensure that you take the courses you need for the particular major that you're interested in and keep you on track. And if you feel that, for instance, you can't take 15 units per semester, which is considered a full load, then you take some summer school or intersession classes and you can complete that 30 units per year that you need to finish in four.
Now, let me interject. For those of you who are undeclared, I want to separate you for just a moment. There are those of you who are undeclared who are interested in STEM, which is science, technology, engineering, mathematics. And then there are those of you who are undeclared who are not. Do not get into this mentality that says to yourself, I'm just going to come here my first 2 years and take GE, and then I'm going to jump into my major. It is very important that you work with an advisor to identify a major. And here's why. Depending on the major you select, there are lower division courses. And let's talk about lower and upper division for just a moment. When you hear us use the term lower division, we're talking about classes that are primarily taken by freshmen and sophomores. When you hear us use the term upper division, we're talking about classes that are taken by juniors and seniors. Now, depending on your major, you may have multiple sequential courses that you need to take in order to be eligible for your major later on. That's particularly important with respect to STEM, because in most STEM, there's going to be a math sequence. If there's not a math sequence, in addition to the math sequence, there's going to be some kind of lower level science sequence. So the point I'm trying to make is, because classes have to be taken sequentially, if you simply come in here and take GE for the first 2 years, you may find yourself in a position at the end of your 60th unit where you're still on your second biology class. And because of that, you can't go any further. So it's important that you work with advisors closely to make sure there's not a track that you're supposed to be traveling that you don't know about so that you don't get stuck later on the back end. So advising is very important. You don't necessarily have to know everything that you need to do right now walking in the door, but you need to work with somebody so that they can map out various possibilities and scenarios for you so you don't get in trouble on the back end. The other group I want to address are those of you who are coming in with credit. There are a number of you who are coming in with credit because you took some classes at community college. Some of you have IB credit. But the point is you're walking through the door, and when you walk through the door, you're going to be a second semester sophomore when you get here. Okay, it's going to be very important when you meet with advisors to let them know how many units you have up front. The reason for that is you don't want to be frustrated when you get here about what you can't take because of what you've already taken. And the next thing you know, we have to throw you in upper division courses you're not ready for. So the point I'm trying to make is advising is very important. Don't take it for granted that you just come in here and start picking classes, start taking. And it doesn't matter whether you go to San Jose State or anywhere else. This advice is true across the board. So like I said, at San Jose State, what I can guarantee you is you have about 16 professionals that are raring to go to help you get where you need to go and to make sure that you understand what the rules are. Because make no mistake about it, going to the university is like playing a big board game. And the very first thing you need to do when you get here is learn the rules. The second thing you need to do is you need to master the rules, and then we need to develop a strategy for you to win. Okay, so that's our role. Our role is to help you win.
There was a great question here about advising right now for admitted students before classes begin. I'll let you talk about that, Michael, because I know that's happening next week, but I also wanted to share with students that there are some resources in the catalog, and Ashley put the catalog URL in the chat earlier on. It's catalog.sjsu.edu. If you look at a particular major, any major in the catalog, when you go to there, you can click on a link and it says roadmap. And it says, and you can click on that link to the roadmap for that major. And it shows you the classes you would take semester by semester to complete that major in 4 years. That is a great resource, even without an advisor, to start understanding what the particular sequence of courses you need to complete a major in a timely fashion. Michael, do you want to talk about the advising later this week?
Yes, you will have a couple of opportunities to meet with advisors this week. I believe one is Thursday at 2 p.m. For those of you who are undeclared pre-nursing, I believe you guys are also going to meet Thursday at 2 p.m. So that's going to be Thursday, April 15th. You'll be meeting with us at 2 p.m. For undeclareds who are not pre-nursing, you will have a second opportunity, which is going to be Tuesday, April 20th. So you're going to have two times, you're going to have Thursday, April 15th, and you're going to have Tuesday, April 20th. And you'll be able to get your advising questions answered. But one thing I do want to let you know about San Jose State, we are an impacted campus, and there are a lot of impacted campuses. So let me tell you what that word means. It has a double meaning. Impacted essentially means we have a lot of people here and we're trying to fill seats. But it is also a designation from the chancellor's office. And with that designation comes the ability of individual programs to admit people into the major. So one of the reasons that you want to connect with your undeclared advisors when you get here is because you want to be clear that you know what the impaction criteria is for the major that you want to get into. So there's two questions that you have to be able to answer for yourself. One is, what do I need to do to get into the major I want? And then the second question is, after I get into the major I want, what do I need to do to get out of here? The roadmap answers the question, what do I need to do to get out of here? It doesn't answer the question, what do I need to do to get into here? Okay. So it's going to be very important that you work with your undeclared advisors to first make sure you have a pathway into a major. And then afterwards, you're going to work with the major department to make sure you have a pathway out of here. Okay. So if you put it all together and you work with everybody that we have for you, you can get out of here in 4 years. You definitely can. But you're going to have to work for it. You're going to have to want to do it. You're going to have to ask yourself, what am I willing to sacrifice? Am I willing to put up the video game for a couple hours and bust the books? Am I willing to go to summer school? And just so you know, we have two summer sessions. So you have the ability to kind of double up in the summertime. And we also have a winter session. So we have opportunities for you to go to school year round. So it is definitely possible to get out of here 4 years between the summer and the winter sessions, as well as the semesters.
I want to answer a question. I kind of answered it a little bit in the Q&A, but it was about the Humanities Honors Program, and the student wanted to know if the Humanities Honors Program is useful if you're not a humanities major. And the answer is absolutely. That's an amazing program. It's an interdisciplinary program where they combine eight GE courses into one four semester sequence. You get your writing, your oral communication, your US history, literature, arts. And the group of faculty work together in a very close knit cohort model with a small numbers of students to explore all the interactions between these pieces of humanities and arts. So yeah, if you're interested in that, I would highly recommend that you attend a session, find out a little bit more about it, and take the humanities honors sequence.
In the chat, I put the schedule so you can see when you'll be able to meet with advisors, whether you're undeclared or undeclared pre-nursing. You'll also see who the advisors are going to be. So if you just refer to the chat, you'll see that information.
So one of the students here just asked this question about why is everyone so concerned about graduating in 4 years? And is it just due to being undeclared, or is it just hard to graduate in 4 years? It's not hard to graduate in 4 years if you take 15 units per semester and you work with an advisor to ensure that you're taking the right classes. And that's the really key thing. It's about being focused and not taking classes that you don't need. If you really want to graduate in 4 years, you need to sort of keep with the program that you're interested in. As Michael mentioned, for instance, if you're interested in one of the STEM majors, you want to start by making sure you take that math and science during your freshman year, so you have the prerequisites you need. So no, we have lots of students who graduate in 4 years, but I think it's really, really important. I think Michael and I have stressed this many times, meeting with your advisor is so important to help ensure that you are on the right path to graduating in 4 years.
Okay. Let me make a comment, because I think I understand what you're asking. So let me say it like this. We are not trying to rush you out of here, okay? Right. I know you're here in 4 years for tonight. So don't misinterpret what we're saying. We're not trying to tell you that as soon as you get here, we're going to shoot a gun in the air, and then you all have to race to 4 years. That's not what we're trying to say. We were just answering a previous question that someone had asked, and what they asked was, can you graduate in 4 years? So that's how we got into the four-year conversation. This is not Thalia and I saying, you got 4 years to get here and we're going to clock you. That's please, please, please do not interpret that this way. Average graduation, just so you know, is about 5 years, 5.5 years. Okay. So there are no people that are standing there who are going to put handcuffs on you and drag you off campus. None of that's going to happen. So we definitely want you to enjoy your college experience. Enjoy. We want you to enjoy your college experience. You know, when I was little, people used to say you eat too fast. Well, okay, I'm going to apply that to this. We don't want you to come in here and just woof it down, okay? We don't want you to be a professional student. Now, that's the flip side. Nobody's expecting you to be here, let's say, 9 years into the future. However, here's when you graduate. You graduate when you're finished, okay? This is not prison. I always tell students, this is not prison. You don't come here and do your time, and then after you do your time, we just hand you a degree. That's not what this is. This is not prison. This is an educational institution whose sole function is your personal development and growth. And people grow at different pace. So take your time, get your growth, get your education. And for those of you who want to get out of here in 4 years, we're just trying to tell you, yes, we can facilitate that. So that's all we were trying to say. So I hope that made that clear.
So it looks like we've come to the end of our half hour. It's been such a pleasure. What an engaged audience you've been. I really appreciate it. We didn't get to every single question, but I encourage you to meet with the advisors on the days and times that Michael put into the chat. And if we didn't answer one of your questions, you can ask it then. I hope that we'll be seeing you in the fall on campus. Really looking forward to it, and thank you for joining us today.